Welcome to Lab 7. In this lab, you will learn how to launch an exploit against a remote environment, such as a web server. We have two learning objectives in this lab. After completing this lab, you will be able to apply previously learned exploit technique to the remote environment, so you can recognize the challenges unique to the remote setting. In this week's tutorial, you will learn a basic tool to write an exploit for remote environment. There are a few restrictions in the remote setting. First, they typically have limited attack surface. For example, an attacker cannot inject the payload through environment variable anymore. Second, probabilistic mitigation such as ASLR become much effective in the remote setting. I'd like to emphasize that our threat model, attackers know the exact binary, the running program in the remote environment. In this week's challenges, there are two ways you can connect to the server. In most cases, you can connect to the remote server through a terminal client such as Netcat. But if remote servers pick a particular protocol, you should use a specialized client. For example, to access the web server, you need a client that speaks the HTTP protocol such as web browser. To access the tutorial, you first have to log into the server hosting Lab 7 challenges. So please find the exact information in separate material. Once logged into the server, you can find the README files under the tutorial remote directory, which describes the detail of each step that you should follow. In each challenge directory, you can also find the access information of each challenge. In the tutorial directory, you can find a target program. If you want to play with the server program, you can launch the server with an ampersand so that it runs as a background. You can access the server by using the Netcat program. When connected, it displays a welcome message and waits for your input. It's a simple game that plays rock, paper, scissors. To get the flag, you should win the game but 5 times in straight. Of course, you can manually try, but it's unlikely that you will win the game. Your task is to find a better way. Yes, vulnerability to find two in the game. To help you, we also provide a template Python program that you can extend. This Python script describes a simple use case of pwn tool. It first connects to the local host at the port 9736 and receives one line to it a banner message. Then it sends a username test as a string. Once the connection is established, you can now play the game. In this template, we are always sending rocks and check if we win the game. If we win 5 times in straight, we terminate the program. When you're writing your exploit for remote environment, please use this Python template as a baseline. In summary, we will apply exploit techniques that we have studied so far to the remote environment. I'm sure you will enjoy a variety of remote games that we prepare for this week. Happy hacking!